here it is, the bass that is a solo, possibly duo bass. It looks big and mean, but it's mainly just an illusion. And this thing is one tough cookie. So let's get down to it, and I'll give you the grand tour and see if you guys like it also. So let's just go in the front door here. Do-do-do, open up faster. All right, here's a little entrance. You enter in the honeycomb. When you log off, you actually put a double door right here. And in the honeycomb, you see I don't have a second floor, just so you don't pickaxe anything or get any type of advantage on the second floor. Here's where you start out. Here's your main room in the beginning. Got a couple furnaces, the fire, because food's a thing now. And three large boxes should be plentiful for you in the beginning. This ladder hatch should just open the wrong way. All right, let's get up here. I'll show you some more. All right. I want to get up here. Let's try to get up here again. Oh my goodness, this stupid thing. Come on, let's go. All right, this ladder hatch. All right, thank you. Ruined my video, jerk. Here is a little other storage room. Use it for one, whatever you want. Dump off anything. Here's your repair bench, more storage. Put the light there for a little effect. Here's my main loot room, actually, right down there. It's, everyone thinks loot rooms are always up on top, and I've tricked a lot of people where they raid the top of the base and all my loot's fine on the bottom. It happens all the time. Up here is my little, tricking raid room. I taunt them with these boxes with cold locks on them, and they go for them every single time. They're like, oh, there's good loot there, let's blow it up. And I put some in just to make them feel better. But here's my little catwalk battle station area. I can run all over 360 degrees. I have protection, I have access. I can see whatever's coming, any direction, which is very helpful for a single player. Coming behind, I see them. Then I also put the hatches down, so if they're on my walls, you pop that sucker open and you can still get them. This is crucial for solo players or even a duo group. Like, you need to be able to defend and stay safe, because if you're down, that's pretty much you lost all your gear. And this is gonna go upstairs right now. This is my little attic area. You have more additional rooms for loot. And I spread the boxes out up here, just one in each, so it's more resources for them to waste. And it's... they're not going to come into a little solo base with all this. This big room, you can put whatever you want. A couple boxes, a research table. That's up to you. This is my top level battle station. This is for more, like, I can see people out in the field and not below me, so I'm not worrying about them. It's usually good for teamwork. Someone's on the bottom, you're on top. And that's basically it. Let's get to the build. All right, right here, guys, I'll show you a base build that's bigger than ours. It's a 3x5, and we offer double the protection and a perfect raid. On the numbers and the colors on the left-hand side, upper corner, shows you how many walls you have to get through just to get to the center cupboard. And with that all being said, now I'm gonna show you how to build all this, so sit down and enjoy the build. All right, base building time, my favorite part of the game, right in the beginning. Foundation as low as you can, ramp up, get your foundations down. This is gonna help you with the stone gate putting out front where you can jump on it and run around. And when you place your cupboard, make sure you upgrade a stone. This is incredibly way easier to do on this than the damn wood. Actually, wood you could probably do it fine, but you're not gonna upgrade wood. Upgrade this one to stone. This is gonna be your core, so you need your core strong. The placement's right in the back corner. It takes a little bit to get used to, but bam, right there, first try. I am pretty happy with that. That is flush. Now we're gonna go up here and we're putting down the third foundation. It's our little beginning trap room. And all right, lag, awesome. This is an early trap room, because you don't really do anything. People just think they can hedgehog up or boost up, but you don't put a ceiling up. You just don't put it up. They're gonna fall in and they're gonna be like, oh, let me out, dude, let me out. And if you have grenades, you can just go up top, toss up your grenades, kill them, hop down, get his stuff, build some stairs, destroy your stairs, and you have some guns now. And it has happened. It's happened to me twice. But I also played on very aggressive servers with a lot of people, and this base has held its ground. Now here I'm going to put down this wall, show you that it's not going to go through the cupboard I'm talking about. And now that it's nice and flush in that corner, now we're going to place our first box. You see that line right there in the stone in the front of the cupboard where I'm trying to line up to? When you line up there, you can get down your sleeping bag and all the other stuff. It's too far out. It is such a pain. Put that first, then your sleeping bag. I put my sleeping bag a couple times first, and it doesn't work out. It's annoying. And also, get another furnace in there. You can fit it. You need your doors. Get it there. And like I said before, food's an issue. So instead of having another cupboard there, not cupboard, another storage, I put an extra furnace and fireplace. I have to go in the bottom right corner to get the U-shaped stairs to do this. That's just how I have to do it. I'm just showing you guys that it is. It's looking sharp now. Then right here, you're going to do the same thing with the boxes. You want to make sure that guy's nice. And right there looks pretty good. Yeah, right there. Then up here, just practice making things flush. Like, man, that looks pretty sharp, man. Pretty sharp. And you can build this real quick. Just make a junk shack. Get all your supplies. Come out here real quick. You can make that really fast. But I would suggest making an airlock when you do this. Don't just make that one door. You'll shoot yourself in the foot. Make sure you come with enough supplies. Make this wood. Make that ceiling wood. You have to chop through it later to put down a hatch. Or if you're prepared enough and you come over the hatch, you can already pop up a hatch up there. That's fine. I'm going to also show you that you guys can die and spawn back there. Some people think the stairs will mess you up. Nope, here I am. Perfect, perfect, baby. Alright, now I'm going to show you how to build this in fast motion and on 4-5. I'm going to stop a few times just to explain a few key elements of building this so you don't build it wrong. Enjoy the watch, guys. Alright, right here is one of the things I want to talk to you guys about. This is a common mistake I see when people try this build. Here, they're going to build this double wall first. There's going to be a severe issue and you're going to destroy the base unless you want to pickaxe a stone triangle for a while. And I'm just going to show you what people do. It's just so if you're a visual learner, it makes a little bit more sense. See right here, I'm like, alright, I'm in good shape. Bam, no I'm not. Base is going to be screwy. Now the trick is the front, I'm counting as a door, and the back of the 3x1 is where you need to build your triangles first. See how it all just went down right there? Perfect. These triangles have to be built up first. I mean, walls go up first also. Like I'm just saying, I'm just doubling it again just so you get the picture. If you go on the side and the triangle in the front's built, you're fine, see? And if you go on the back and do it where you think, oh man, I'm just doing a quick build, it's not all right. So do the front and the back of the three triangles first. It is very, very, very important. As you can see, that's a pain in the butt. So it's not hard, just do the build right. and you won't have any issues. You really want a good foundation. You don't want to mess it up. This is why I'm talking about the walls going up first. This is the big trick to this build. I demonstrated actually a little bit incorrectly here, but if I put the wall on the outside walls, I can't build. But you want to go all the way up first. When you build this, make this two floors up. This little first triangle and the back triangle. Because these walls will even mess up when you go up one. So I'm going to actually show that in the video going fast forward. But make sure you bring the front and the back up two floors, then the side walls can go in after. Hope you guys enjoy the rest of the build. And here's going to be the issue if you build up the sidewalls fast. You can go up one floor, but you're going to have to wait to do the second floor till this top floor right here is completed. So I have to destroy that because I can't place a foundation, not foundation, the triangle floor for where I need to go, right there. I'm going to show you on the other side also. You see that one wall sticking up? It won't let me place anything down on it since it's messing it up. All your square foundations need to connect to your 3x1. And you want to have them like right there before. As you see, the triangle won't go right here. Won't go where I need it to go because of that wall. And I'm going to speed up real quick, show you. Those walls are fine. Connected out there. Then you have to build up, get your ladder, build up on the outside. And take a few supplies with you as you feel comfortable because you're actually going to be in a dangerous spot. If you fall in, you're gonna be very screwed.
Is that all you can do? Okay.
Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I'm Snarfimus, and I'll see you in my next video.